not the first exit, it's the second exit, 13 Grantham. And you're going to go south on Route 10. Remember, as a little kid, I was just getting interested in fishing, and I read a book about fly fishing in Yugoslavia. And for some reason, that really tickled my fancy. I thought that sounded great, the beauty of the rivers. We talked about marble trout, and just the sound of that kind of fascinated me. A lot got in the way. You know, I had to grow up and learn how to fly cast and raise a family and so on. And then, of course, there was the Civil War, so nobody was going to fish Yugoslavia for decade anyway. But then finally the kids were graduated from college and we had a little extra cash and we decided to go. Well, I remember our guide Kevin took us and we scoped out a few rivers the first afternoon. I was kind of jet lagged and tired from flying all night. And I remember looking down into the rivers and saying, there are no rivers there. I could see the river bed and I could see the rocks and a little beach along the sides, but there didn't seem to be any water in them. And then I realized it was because it was so clear. I had never seen clearer water, although you can't even say seen clearer water because you can't see it. It's so transparent. A little turquoise tinge here and there makes it even more beautiful. But fishing in September, I was absolutely astonished. And I thought we had clear water in New England, but it's murky compared to Slovenia water. Yeah, the crazy thing about Slovenia is that we came back and even before we went, people said, where are you going on vacation? And we did not meet two people out of probably several dozen educated people we talked to and told them about plans who knew where the place was. And of course, they all scratched their head and finally come out with, oh, Slovakia, because they've all heard of that. But and the funny thing is the people we met who did know where Slovenia was, it was because they'd all been there five or six times. I mean, they just absolutely were in love with it. It's a real undiscovered treasure. I would like to go back at the height of the mayfly season, which I guess is late June, maybe July, because to see a fish full of rising fish really is kind of a magical experience. And I understand it can be fantastic. So I'd like to do that. Yeah, I have fantasies about renting a house there for a fire summer. And, you know, every once in a while, I do something like that. So maybe someday. But the other great thing about it, there are many places in the world where there are so many rivers and so many alternatives within half day's drive. I mean, you could literally fish six rivers a day and hardly put on more than 50 miles out of your car. And that's what I like. If one river isn't fishing well, you go to another. I'm tired of fishing in Socha, you can go to a smaller river. I like the variety. I like the relatively compact area that these rivers are found in. Yeah, well, I'm something of a World War I buff, and I know a lot of fishermen probably could care less about history. But for me, there was almost a second level to the fishing, knowing a little something about the history and what happened there in 1917 in particular. Some of the bloodiest and most forgotten, I would say, fighting of the First World War. You can walk anywhere back in from the river and come in the forest and come upon old dugouts, trenches. We found an old latrine, very obviously a latrine. And it's as beautiful as it is, as pristine as it is. In a crazy kind of way, it's haunted. And to me, that made it even more interesting. And I would encourage anybody who goes there to spend an hour or two in the Corbett World War I Museum, which is a very poignant, very moving experience.